Well, I read about it, perhaps like many on this call, heard a description of it. As I understand it, it was filed in federal court here in Pierce County, and it challenges two things. It challenges the continuation of the governor's determination that we're in a disaster or emergency, I should say. So it challenges that issue. Are we still in that emergency? And then the second issue I think it raises then is, if so, has the governor's order sort of treated fairly evenly different groups that are similarly situated? For example, I know one of the issues they raise has to do with construction. For the first number of weeks, the governor's order allowed for construction in the public sector on public projects and affordable housing, but forbade it when it came to the private sector for residential and commercial. That struck many of us as odd and difficult to square. If it was safe to do public construction, why wouldn't it couldn't it be using the same protocols be equally safe to do private construction? Ultimately, the governor gave on that and is allowing some limited private construction that was commenced before his order. He's allowing that construction to resume, still forbidding new construction, new commercial residential construction. And I think this lawsuit sort of tests that distinction the governor made in his order. We have it's probably this is a good chance to talk a little bit about basic civics. The way we have, at the national and state level divide power, we have the governor who's the chief executive, and he's exercising obviously that power with the stay-at-home order. We have the legislature that can write laws to expand or contract that power. We're not in session, so can't weigh in on that issue between legislative sessions. It's the courts then that are often that place of testing and asking whether the governor or the legislature, for that matter, has overstepped its bounds constitutionally. And so that's what these plaintiffs are doing. They're testing this order of the governor's in court, which we've seen, lot at, whether it's at the national level, lawsuits have been brought against actions taken by the chief executive, the president. We're seeing that now with our governor, our state executive. That's what the courts are for, and so those issues will be tested. And that's as much as I know about that lawsuit.